Hi, and welcome to the AYTM.com VanKonan Price Optimization tutorial video. The Price Optimization Model, or POM, is also known as VanKonan. It's named after AYTM's data scientist, Ivan Konanykhin, who helped develop the model. It's a very efficient way to get clarity on vital business questions. It can handle a wide range of business models, from consumer packaged goods to SaaS businesses and service companies. Like other AYTM advanced research tests, VanKonan is designed to be so easy to set up and interpret that it doesn't require any research training whatsoever. All you need is an overall understanding of your business's objectives and market realities to set it in motion. Based on a few easy-to-answer questions that the model will generate, your survey will gather enough information to connect all the dots, analyze the dependencies, and output a sophisticated prediction of acceptable price ranges and optimal price points for such fundamental business goals as maximizing revenue, profit, and/or frequency of sales. What's more, results will be presented with automatically generated executive summary findings and interactive charts, allowing clients to run unlimited what-if scenarios post-fielding. The VanKonan model incorporates the Van Westendorp price sensitivity meter as a starting point. If you're not familiar with the Van Westendorp model, it asks each respondent four very specifically worded questions about the price, starting from, at which point would you consider the price to be so cheap that you would think it couldn't be a quality product, all the way through, so expensive that you wouldn't consider purchasing it. Respondents are prompted to enter a numeric value in each field, but custom validation on this question will not allow them to advance to the next question unless each value they enter is greater than the one above it to maintain the logic of the methodology. This secures more thoughtful answers and prevents illogical completes, which would reduce your usable sample size. Based on the collected answers, Van Westendorp will report what the customer's expectations of the price will be, graphically plotting 4 to 6 curves to identify the optimal price point and acceptable price range. The limitation of this test is that it doesn't take into consideration such vital business realities as likelihood of purchase, total addressable market, cost of goods, or frequency of purchase, making the findings only somewhat representative of consumers' desired price. Van Westendorp often reports a price that is divorced from profitability and lower than what consumers would be willing to pay in real life, provided that the quality, distribution, marketing, competitive positioning, etc. are favorable and well executed. Our VanKonan research test goes well beyond the Van Westendorp test and addresses these issues. With the addition of a couple easy-to-answer questions, it measures the probability and frequency of purchase at each of the key price points. Coupled with the information you enter into the model, such as your total addressable market, estimated retail price, and the cost of goods, VanKonan fills in all the remaining pieces of the puzzle to build a comprehensive and flexible model, which I'll show in a bit. VanKonan is very sensitive to the number of survey completes, so we recommend ordering 650 to 1,000 responses. We can't launch it with fewer than 400 responses ordered. We recommend using it as a second stage price study after you have figured out your target audience and total addressable market, and followed by a more precise and expensive price methodology, such as a monadic price test or qualitative research. Let me show you how to set up a VanKonan study. First, choose what you would like to optimize the price for. You have four options here. 1. Run price sensitivity only, which is the Van Westendorp. 2. Add the maximum revenue price optimization module. 3. Add the maximum sales frequency price optimization module. 4. Add the maximum profit price optimization module. The fourth option gives you an all-inclusive VanKonan package. Each module adds a bit to the cost of the study, allowing you to do as much or as little as you need and as fits your budget. Some products are considered one-time purchases, like buying a house, a car, or a boat. While these purchases may happen several times over the course of a customer's life, it may not be practical to calculate the frequency in one experiment. For such cases, you can turn the sales frequency optimization off while keeping all other modules on. Other than that, the modules cascade down, which means that each module relies on the inclusion of all the previous ones. Under the main menu, we'll ask you to enter your best guess of the optimal price. The main purpose for this field is to learn the format of units in which you want to run the experiment. We will mimic your format for each sub-question for respondents. For example, you can enter $100, 36 pounds, 50 euros, or $10. The other purpose is to show you what revenue and profit your projected price would result in. The amount that you predict will not be visible to respondents and will not affect their answers, but the format you use may have a huge impact on the answers. Please test your survey in preview mode before launching. Below the estimated price field, we'll ask for the proper way to refer to the thing you're selling, a product, a service, a package, and so on, plus the verb that best describes the sale event, such as purchase, subscribe, or sign up. We'll need the proper words to describe the findings of the model and share the story with you. If the revenue price optimization module is on, we'll ask you to give us your best guess of the total addressable market. There are a few ways you can go about it. You can be more inclusive and use the entire universe of potential customers or households that may, in theory, buy your product. This will create the most optimistic revenue forecast and will give you the best case, but likely unrealistic, scenario. Alternatively, you can take that number and reduce it to a realistic subset of buyers whom you expect to be aware of your offering and in a position to consider purchasing it. You will have to consider your marketing efforts, competition, release schedule, production, distribution, and competition, which is, well, a lot of assumptions or an educated guess. Unfortunately, artificial intelligence is not at a point yet to make these assumptions for you. The good news is that you can leave this field at the default 1,000 and experiment with other total addressable market sizes when you work with the model after fielding. If frequency optimization is on, we'll ask for a reasonable purchase frequency range for your product. If you're selling movie tickets, some clients might be buying them daily, while others only once a year, but it wouldn't be reasonable to set the lower limit at hours. This range is only for us to find a reasonable set of frequencies for your product. After selecting the overall range, you can click here to adjust the actual phrasing of every stop on the frequency slider that will be presented to respondents. You can express the same frequency in several different ways. For example, one a day can be expressed as 365 times a year. Different products and purchase patterns work better with different expressions. Some products, like canned food or flour, we typically buy in bulk and then use for months until the next trip to the store. While others, like fruit or music on iTunes, are typically purchased on a daily or weekly basis. Finally, if the profit optimization module is on, we'll ask you to fill out the unit cost fields. Now, don't be alarmed. This information is definitely not for respondents' eyes. It will only be visible to you and anyone with whom you decide to share the survey results. You can enter your cost for a single unit and be done, or add more lines to the grid and add additional price breaks if your product or service becomes cheaper for you with increased quantity. Say to produce 1,000 wearable devices, you'd pay $300 per unit, but if you ordered 1,000,000 of them, you'd be able to lower the unit cost to $75. We can accommodate a grid with up to 10 lines and even calculate smooth transitions among the price points for you if your cost incrementally diminishes with every unit. Don't forget to include a good description of your product or service before the VanKonan question or write in the question field. We give you up to 650 characters to tell the story here. You can attach an illustration as well or preface the test with a video question. It's good to make sure that respondents fully appreciate the value proposition of your product before asking them price-related questions. It's also very important to make sure that your survey is targeted to a qualified set of respondents. You'll get unrealistically low price estimates if you ask the wrong group of people about a product they would never consider buying. Please watch the Target Market tutorial video to learn more about how to pinpoint your sample, or call us if you need any assistance with it. That's all it takes to set up the VanKonan research test. Before launching, please test the survey in the Respondents mode of the preview to make sure all the VanKonan component questions look right. When your survey is fulfilled, you'll have a host of useful information at your fingertips. Let's take a look. If you ordered the smallest package, which only includes price sensitivity, the Van Westendorp part will look like this. Right below a short paragraph summarizing the findings, you'll have a clear visual representation of the acceptable price range and optimal price point according to the cumulative prediction of respondents' price sensitivities. This test features more accurate intersection calculation formulas than are commonly used in the market research industry. This chart shows the acceptable price range with the optimal price point according to the Van Westendorp model. The table below will give you more detailed information, as well as your price guess. Please read the disclaimer before quoting the numbers or using them in your business decisions. Let's now switch to an example that features VanKonan in all its glory where all modules are enabled. You'll see a summary chart with two curves, one for revenue and one for profit. You will also notice a few price points, one predicts the break-even point, one predicts the price for attaining the highest revenue, and one predicts the price for attaining the highest profit. Two additional points without markets will be color-coded and referenced below in the table as the Van Westendorp optimal price point from the Van Westendorp model and the price you gave us as an estimate. Below the chart, you'll find the key takeaway points. The table below will give you detailed information about each price point, the estimate of the buyers and corresponding percentage of your total addressable market, the average expected frequency of purchase in the selected time frame, total sales volume, revenue, cost, as well as profit and loss. The profit cells for the best yielding price points will be highlighted in green, while the cells resulting in loss will be highlighted in orange. Let's take a look at the features that make the model so interactive and useful for running an unlimited number of what-if scenarios post-fielding. First, you'll be able to enter any price estimate into this field, and once updated, see what would happen with revenue, profit, and sales frequency at that retail price. Second, you'll be able to edit your cost. You'll see the familiar price grid and be able to adjust it here if you find a new vendor or the cost changed since you last launched the study. The third button allows you to change the total addressable market to run different scenarios. If you ordered purchase frequency optimization, you'll see a combo box in the top right corner of the chart. Changing the value here will recalculate the revenue and profit totals for the optimal price points on the chart and several columns in the table below. If you click anywhere in the chart, the labels will start following you as you move your mouse horizontally across the x-axis, showing you on the fly what your profit and revenue would be at any given price point. To switch back to the optimal price points, click again anywhere within the chart. I saved the most exciting part for the end. You may have noticed the Open Infographic button here, and it does what it promises. Click it, and it will produce an interactive and detailed infographic describing the entire VanKonan model process step by step. You'll be able to see the Van Westendorp chart and read the story it tells about price sensitivity. We'll show you what the purchase probability curve looks like. We'll describe what the total addressable market means and which value it's currently using. The slider and the field below allow you to play with the number and see the entire model recalculate the forecast and redraw the infographic for you in real time. The next section will show you the purchase frequency and describe any peaks we saw in the data. As on the summary chart, you will have the ability to change the range using this combo box. Finally, at the bottom, you will see a paragraph with a detailed description of the maximum revenue and profit analysis, an overall interactive chart, table, and key takeaway points. As with a standalone Van Westendorp model, it's important to be aware of the assumptions we used and limitations of the predictive power of the model. Please read the disclaimer before quoting the numbers or using them in your business decisions. You can save any chart from the infographic by using the download menu. When you're done exploring it, you can safely close it here and return to the more compact summary view. And there you have it, a fully automated, robust price optimization model that does the heavy lifting for you, from survey design and statistical analysis to storytelling and visualization. With a few clicks required on your part, you can save a tremendous amount of time and focus on what you do best, understanding and navigating your business, leveraging your field expertise, predicting competitors' moves, providing better strategy calls, and forecasting financial outcomes for a multitude of possible scenarios. Thanks again for watching, and feel free to ping us with questions or to set up a personal demo. AYTM, so advanced, it's easy.